I'm standing outside one of the largest diameter bore tunnels in the world. Behind me is a double-deck roadway under construction inside that very tunnel. Now let me take you inside and show you how a road and a tunnel can be built at the same time. So Bertha's not just mining and removing dirt, but she's actually building the tunnel. She installs the concrete ring, the circle, that's made up of 2-foot-thick concrete segments. So the segments all have to go in really like a jigsaw puzzle. So they have to fit just perfectly. When enough of the tunnel is built, the contractor can start building the road inside. Because it's a circle, they need to develop a foundation, a point from which to place the walls and the decks. And that foundation is called a corbel. And the corbels are built, as all the roadway structures are, in 54-foot sections. All the concrete work out here is reinforced with what's called rebar, reinforcing steel, to help deal with expansion and contraction of the concrete. So that steel is placed up against the walls of the tunnel, and then the workers come along and construct formwork. So after the formwork's been installed, they come in and begin to pour the concrete into the corbel formwork. After just a few days, when everything's set up, they remove that formwork and they place moisture and blankets over the concrete, and they'll allow it to cure for another 28 days. Concrete will actually gain in strength with time. So while that crew is on the corbels, the crew behind them will begin bringing in the formwork to actually build the walls, and the walls will sit on top of each of those two corbels. The wall's built like an upright sandwich with forms on either end and steel and concrete in the middle. There's 13 tons of steel in each of these 54-foot panels. Once the reinforcing steel's set, the forms are placed in to create this sandwich. Then that same pump truck comes along and pours the concrete into that form. Along the way, the workers are making sure that it's flowing and then verifying at the very end the depth of that concrete till it reaches the very top of the formwork, and they're finished with the pour. The concrete is allowed to set for a few days, long enough that they can remove the formwork, and then similarly with the corbels, they'll spray it with water and they'll wrap it in plastic blankets. Again, 28 days until it's reached the design strength. And the next step is to set that upper roadway on top of the two walls that they just built. There's plenty of room underneath that upper roadway deck to access the tunnel boring machine. And the crews need to be able to reach the machine, bring in the precast segments underneath that upper roadway deck to continue this mining operation. So the formwork will be placed between the two walls. They'll actually apply an oil-based product to prevent the concrete from sticking to the formwork. The reinforcing steel will be placed on top of that formwork. And this is a special type of reinforcing steel. It's covered with an epoxy coating. Those reinforcing bars would be more susceptible to corrosion if they were not wrapped in an epoxy. And then the crew will come in to pour the concrete on that upper deck. And this is quite an operation. Everybody has a job to do, whether it's managing the concrete that's flowing out of the nozzle, or the placement of the nozzle, or smoothing the concrete as it's building in certain areas. The public won't see the walls very well, but you'll feel that roadway surface as you're driving along, and you want to get the absolute highest quality of concrete and finishing as you can. The contractor will build walls above that upper deck, and at the very end of the project, we'll come in and we'll finish that lower roadway that nestles on top of those two corbels. In the interest of time and efficiency, this is the one piece of the whole operation that is precast, which means it's made off-site and then brought in and set into place at the very end. The amount of concrete used to build the tunnel roadway structure is enough concrete to build 9 Seattle football stadiums. When it's complete, the SR-99 tunnel will be one of the longest roadway tunnels in the U.S. and pave the way to transform Seattle's waterfront.